WNBA. I mean, you on the clock. Oh, yeah, now you on the clock. Because I'm, listen, I didn't subscribe and paid for WNBA TV. Okay? I'm tapping in every day. Watching Caitlin Clark. And all I'm seeing and hearing is a bunch of nonsense. A bunch of it. And I'm getting disgusted with it. I really am. Okay? It's bad basketball being played. And then y'all trying to keep Caitlin Clark from scoring for 30. And like she really can. You see she's very capable of doing so. But every team, it seems, every team want to double her for the majority of the game. Why? And for her players, her teammates, not to know how to take advantage of 4-on-3 situations, 5-on-4 situations, 3-on-2, 2-on-1. For you, I don't understand. Y'all supposed to be professionals. That's why this is looking ugly. And then it seems like y'all have not hired a PR team for your teams. Get that done. Because it seems every time one of them, even from your coaches, get the microphone in front of their face and get asked about Caitlin Clark, they got to say something crazy. Instead of just, you know, yes, being thankful. Because you should be thankful. People say, oh, yeah, well, they're supposed to kiss her ass. No, you should at least be thankful. Because without her, you and this is clear as day. Without her, there are no charter flights. Without her, you don't have a packed arena like as if it's a championship game. And y'all don't even get that in the championship games. What she bringing to the table is so much and is so clear to see that she is the reason. Y'all have sold more WNBA merch already in this span of time than you did all last year. So, yes, reporters are going to ask you about the Caitlin Clark effect because it is real. It's an effect. It's happening. Money for everybody can go up. The eyes are able to watch y'all play now. And even if they didn't know who you was before, you can show them better than you can tell them. Or say how much you feel is racist or how much you feel it's only because she's white or, you know, you don't care if Kermit the Frog got the charter flights or just. I mean, it's on and on and on. And so why the WNBA allows this and why they don't have no PR team to say, no, that's not. We want to promote the game. And she right now is our game. Every time you play against her, our advice to you is to bust her ass. Match her point for point. Because that's going to make the game exciting. If Caitlin Clark is going off 25, 30 points, and somebody on the opposing team, whether it's Kelsey Plum, Brianna Stewart, or Lloyd, or going off with her, Cameron Brink from the Sparks, if it's a game, that's what the fans want to see. And then they'll start coming, you know, more familiar with all these other girls. They names. Start going on. So how about ESPN and like First Take and FS1? How about y'all start leading in with these type of topics? Caitlin Clark, y'all do LeBron James topics every day. Dak Prescott and Dallas Cowboys topics every day. They ain't even in season. But every day. Now you have a super change in the WNBA because of one person. And that's no slight against the other women. Y'all just have not been entertaining enough for people to want to tap in to watch your games. And if you have been, the WNBA has been failing you. Not Caitlin Clark or Caitlin Clark's fans. The WNBA has been failing you. If you've been like that and they haven't been promoting the top players that's like that, shame on them, right? It's not Caitlin Clark's fault. Just say, okay, now you get to see. Let your play do the talk and talk your talk on the court. Why are you allowing your play to do the talking? But off the court, too many of y'all just being very underappreciative and very dismissive and disrespectful all at the same damn time. And it's getting ugly. You understand? It's getting ugly. It's a turnoff. So y'all can try to appease the people that's been watching the WNBA and they feel it's a turnoff. The fact that y'all, Caitlin Clark is getting talked about in the fashion she is. Y'all can try to appease them and go back to less than mediocrity. Go back to allowing the NBA to take care of y'all, and y'all can go back to commercial flights and so on and so forth. But this allowing every team to double Caitlin Clark and try to get the ball out of her hands when y'all don't do that to no other player, and not even in WNBA history have you done this. This is unprecedented. It seems to me it is an agenda to make sure she don't go off and make y'all league look like, okay, like her really what it has been. Not that good. Overall, yes, there are certain players in a talentless league that showed up and put up some good numbers, but it wasn't exciting to watch. Like the other night, Asia Wilson, she put up 29. But what was exciting about it? I had a young player on my team. He was 12 years old, playing with 14-year-olds. So he was playing up. He was playing with my 14U. And he was 12. He deadly, named Jordan. He put up 29. Lights out. And that was way more entertaining 29 than hers. He was hitting like about 7 threes. Long rangers, pulling up, pump fakes, up and unders. Crazy. This is what, when I say I've seen AAU 13-year-olds look better than they do, even just the knowledge of the game, I'm not, trust me, go on YouTube and type in 13, 14U AAU. Go play and fight 14U boys AAU and see what comes up and go just tap in. I'm trying to tell you. So, y'all just grown. Y'all stronger than the 13-year-old boys should be. Maybe not, I don't know. But y'all, I mean by the smarts of the game. See, they 13, they still learning the nuances. Okay, if you get doubled, this spot is open. If they run a 2-3, this is what open for, this is how you beat a 2-3 zone. This is how you beat a 3-2 zone. You learning that type of stuff at that age. But as far as layups go, you learning that too to become more efficient. You don't got it down pat, but it's about the same. Like the missing makes, the players that's like that, that's 13, 14, that's basically going to be in the league and be something one day. Oh, yeah, they making them same type of shots like Asia Wilson, like Kelsey Plum. They play just like that. It's nothing special. It's nice. You got game, yes. Caitlin Clark been able to pull up comfortably with a beautiful form from 30 beyond. That's special. Her being able to throw full court pinpoint pretty passes on the money. That's special. Bounce passes through two people on the money. Special. So it ain't because she white. And stop acting like she's not like that. She's on the worst team in the WNBA. So it's like, okay, what y'all double her every game, all game long. All right, so you don't want to let her shine none, even though she bringing all the eyes and all the attention and all the money and changing the game, even for the women in the WNBA that she's playing against. Y'all all now have charter flights. I don't care if you've been working on it since 1996. It's something that you've been working on that you could never fix. And then here she came along, fixed it. She's like, oh, here goes the, just do this. Boop, boop, fixed. and you should understand why. You should have enough sense why she was able to fix it. Long rant, her game is exciting. It's more exciting than ours. Okay, so if that's what the people want to see, that's what we might need to start practicing constantly. It looks like nobody really in your game, not nobody, but it don't, the majority, it looks like of you women don't constantly work on your games. Don't constantly watch and know basketball. Know the ins and outs of basketball. I see too many low IQs, not even stopping up, knowing how to stop the ball on a fast break. Y'all keep backpedaling all the way to the paint. I've seen it from every team. You backpedal, like, who is the coach? Y'all don't, nobody tells them you stop the ball. Simple things like that. I'm talking about, that's crazy to me. And so for y'all to try to be so tough on Caitlin Clark, trying so hard to knock her down, that's what it seemed like to me. It ain't even got nothing about no fandom. I got two eyes and a great mind. I see what the hell is going on. And a lot of other people do. So you on the clock. You on the clock. Are we getting tired of watching this? So keep on mucking it up for Caitlin Clark. The only one player that y'all ever had to take you to the next level to actually make your game relevant and have eyes. Man, it's GG. God rest your soul. Shout out to everybody, man. You know what I mean? It is what it is. Let me know what you feel in the comments. Hit the like button. Subscribe to the channel. It's the Pope. Peace and love. I'm out.